Hey you all, God bless you. Welcome to this edition of Mike Reed Outdoors. Thanks a lot for watching. I really do thank you for watching. In this video, some of my blacksmithing friends who are getting into blacksmithing, I said something the other day about showing you how to make a spoon bit. This is a simple drill bit that was designed by the blacksmith for chair makers and people who worked in that industry, beginning somewhere, I think, in like the late 1600s. It's a simple bit to make. It looks complicated, but let me do some close-ups of some bits here, and I will show you how this actually works. Then we'll go forge one. Now you all, of course, this right here is a bracing bit, okay? The bracing bit is designed after this old-fashioned drill bit right here. And it's just a hand-twisted bit. In a minute I'll show you why the chair makers preferred this drill bit instead. See that right there? It's made just like a spoon. Matter of fact, you could dip stuff and eat it out of it if you wanted to. This one has a wooden handle on it. Check that out right there. So now the reason that the chair makers preferred this drill bit right here. See how that's made right there, you all? It's because it cut a smooth hole and you could go in without breaking out the back side of your chair that you were working on, the piece of wood. That's the reason that's designed that way, okay? Now, we know that this particular twisted bit right here, this is a hand-forged bit. I didn't do it, and I really don't even know how to do it. It's got this lead screw right here. This lead screw will come out the back side of a very deep cut if you're not very careful, okay? But if you put that in here, let me just show you what happens. I know you people know how this works, but I'm going to show you anyway. Now see how that sits there? The lead screw pulls the face of this bit into the cut. But when you're making chairs and stuff like that back in the day, you will notice that there is a lot of tear out. You have to sand all this stuff away in your project that you're working on, okay? Where if you use this bit right here to do it, you don't see hardly any tear out at all, and the hole is smooth at the backside and doesn't break out the backside of your project. And that's why these things were actually designed and made for chair makers. Now you all, the first thing that you really want to do is you want to make your handle that you're going to use if you're not going to use a bracing bit. Now I'm going to forge a bit for a bracing bit here, and I'll tell you the reason why here just in a second. Take you a piece of metal and put your square hole in it, or whatever size hole you're going to use first if you're going to do this by hand. And the reason that is because when you're using these bits this way, of course, you have to apply pressure all the time. You hear that bit cutting? You simply have to use a lot of pressure all the time to keep this bit cut, all right? I hope you all can see that right there. They cut a really good smooth hole. This time I'm going to make one of these bits that will work in this bracing bit right here, where you can just put pressure against it and continue to turn like this. And, you know, I know people will say, well, Mike, why would you want to do that right there anyway? So you all will go around and fire up the forge. Now, I made this, you all, out of a piece of rebar. You can see that right there. Rebar has enough carbon in it. Most of it has enough carbon in it to harden good enough to hold a really good edge on the end of your drill bit. So let's go around, fire up the forge, and we're going to make us one that will work in this bracing bit around here, okay? All right, you all, we're getting ready to start the forging right now. Take your piece of rebar, whatever it is you're going to use. If it's soft steel, you will have to case harden it so it'll keep holding edge on it, okay? But start out with, just cut the thing off as square as you possibly can. And we'll forge it out there, and then I'll show you just exactly what to do. Now you all, if you got a little set of hand calipers, this will come in really handy for the job that you're fixing to do, because you can adjust this and make sure you get the size drill bit that you're looking for, okay? So today we're going to try to make a 3/4 inch drill bit. Now the end of your bit here doesn't have to be more than 1.5 inches long, okay? So you should be able to put about 1 inch of it over here and draw that out to get what you want. Go down, you all, to about 1/8 inch thick, okay? Just about right when we turn it up. Okay, now that's long enough to make this drill bit, okay? Now what we're going to do next is we're going to actually thin the edges down with a file or a grinder and round this over on the end to make that shape before we cup it, okay? That way there will be no cold shuts in your edge or the tip of your cutter. A cold shut is where you fold it over a piece of metal and left it in there. Then when you go to sharpen it or try to use it, that cold shut will show up in the edge of your cut. And if you do it this way, it'll save you a whole lot of time on sharpening your bit. It's annealed right now and it's not hard. So you want to take it down just about on both sides, just like this right here. Basically till it's just about sharp enough to cut you, okay? Because if you don't get it sharp, it won't never drill anything. Now, really, you don't really need to come back more than 1/2 inch on the end of your cutter. From the end back to here, that's the only part of this bit that'll ever be cut, and the rest of it is just cleanup, okay? Make sure you get that thing nice and evenly round and straight with your drill bit, okay? Make sure you get it nice and round and straight with your drill bit all the way through. Now right here is a bending die, you all. That's what that is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and forge this bit right down inside that die right there and make that bend in it. Now you can also do it on the corner step of your anvil. But since I have this bending die right here, this is where I'm going to do it for this video. See that? That's what we're trying to do right there. And that looks pretty good too. Now you ought to forge the end of it down the tip of your cutter down to the right shape, you're going to want to use a piece of metal, round metal, where you've smoothed the top of it or rounded it off, so that you can actually bend the shape of your the end of your drill bit around it. And if you make this the size of the actual drill bit that you're trying to make, okay? See that right there? Bring that over right on the very tip of it, and this is all you're going to do right here. You're actually making your cutting tip. Now we're going to forge it to where it'll fit inside our bracing bit. Make sure that thing's straight. Right, very gently, you all, come around there and make sure that that drill bit is flat. That shank with the shank of your drill bit. Okay. It's looking pretty dad burn good to me. So now we will quench it in water. All right, you all, since I just put it through the fire again, the edge is just a little bit on the dull side. So what we'll do is I'll take it right here to this little belt sander and I will just dress up the edge of it. That's just like a little bit rough looking, you all, but let's see if it'll actually work. See how smooth it cuts without tearing out? That's why the chair makers preferred this particular drill bit right here. So last night I will give a shout out to Expeditionary Johnny. If you are not watching his channel, he's an up and coming YouTube channel that's really doing some interesting stuff from the outdoors to, I think he's trying to learn how to forge some items that he can use in his survival kits and stuff. But anyway, check out Expeditionary Johnny's channel. I was on there last night and caught him live and chatted with him there for a minute or two, and he gave me a shout out. So I thought I'd do the same for him. Anyway, you all, that's how you make spoon drill bits. They're not hard to do. They're not complicated at all, especially if you've got just a little old forge that, and it doesn't take very much fire and heat to make these drill bits, okay? But if you want to make it with a handle, like I said, make your handle first with your hole in your metal, okay? So that you know how big to punch or to make the end of your drill bit here so that it'll actually fit in there, all right? So you can either do it like this, which you have to put a whole lot of pressure straight on it all the time, or you can use that bracing bit like I just did right there. All right, you all, until next time, God bless you. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something from it. If you did, I would appreciate it. If it would help my channel out a whole lot if you would share my videos across the internet, okay? And I'll tell you what I'll do. I will share yours as well. So God bless you and have yourself a great day.